Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, the Concept Academy by Idea Solution. My name is Salman, and here we are with a new video related to Docker. So in this video, we are going to have a .NET Core web application, and we are going to run that web application into a Docker container. So let's just start it. So first, I'll be going to the Visual Studio 2019, and then I'll be selecting to create a new project, and it's quite loading now. I'll be selecting ASP.NET Core web application, then click on the next, and I'm writing web Docker demo, name it as, creating this, and my .NET Core, and this is .NET Core 5.0, and select ASP.NET Core web API, then create. Alright, here we are. So once your project is loaded, and let's just build it once. Right click on the project and rebuild it. And first, I'll be running it on IIS to check whether it is fine or not. So let's just check it. So till then, I open the Docker desktop which we have installed in our previous video. So I'll be opening this side of the Visual Studio, and currently the web API is running on this port 443.8 on the IIS. As you can see, the IIS is running right now. So sure, there is an API, so not concerned with the API that what is request and response. So currently our target is to run this API into our Docker container. So in my Docker there, let's just check the image. I have three images right now over here. That is RabbitMQ, which I'm not going to remove, and the second one is React App, and third one is the Ubuntu. And what container is running? None of the containers is running right now. As you can see, there is no .NET application image and no container. So I'll be creating image. So without writing the command in Visual Studio, you can create an image of your web application. Let's just right click on the project and go to the add, and there is a option Docker support. Click on that. It will ask you that what you are targeting OS. So as we have installed the Linux kernel in our previous video, so we can deploy this application into the Linux container also. So I'll be creating the Linux, selecting Linux, and when I select, as you can notice, there is a file added, that is Docker file, and all the command has been already written, so I will not be writing any command and not touching to this file. So without the information of this file, you may create the container. That's the beauty of the Visual Studio. And from now, I'll not be selecting IIS, and I'll be running it to the Docker, and in the output window you can see all the thing which is happening, all the command which is running to, which is required to running the Docker container. All will be showing here. As you can see, Docker minus F bring the container of this. It's creating the image. Now move to the Docker desktop. you will be seeing an image, fab docker demo, and it has started the container. Its name is fab docker demo. Let's just open it in the browser. Okay, it's not completely, it's done now. As you can see, it is working now. Fine. Okay, it's deployed on HTTPS. Fine. And I was running it. So here we are. We have successfully run our ASP.NET web application into a Docker container. As you can see, there is no IIS running. The application is running on Docker container. So that's all from my side. And if you like the video, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video. Allah Hafiz.